Before the war, Copenhagen had been a bustling and vibrant city. I had arrived there as a student, eager to lose myself in the crowded bars and jazz clubs, eager to escape my privileged upbringing. Life in the capital only confirmed what I had read. Injustice, cruelty, and exploitation were everywhere, and the downtrodden working class were hit hardest. Our escape from Copenhagen took us from one end of Denmark to the other. We hid among friendly resistance cells, bypassed Nazi checkpoints, and braved the harsh winter the best we could. On the orders of the Freedom Council, we had made our way to southern Jutland. All that remained was for us to make contact with the local resistance. We had arrived in Tingliv, knowing that the resistance here would be small and ill-equipped. But a guerrilla operation is always about making the most of what you have available. There are never enough resources, enough guns, enough people. So we would have to sculpt Anders and Peter into the fighters that we needed.
Thank you.
The ringing of the church bell sounded out across town. While the locals filed in for Sunday sermon, we prepared to meet our contact. The Gestapo's presence was bound to complicate matters, but this was our best chance to retrieve the intel that we needed.
Thank you.
Over the next few days, we settled back into our routine at the inn. Anas and Benda had located and destroyed the papers incriminating the Snow Fox. All that remained was to receive the final go-ahead from the Freedom Council.
Thank you.
We arrived on the outskirts of town just as night was beginning to settle around us. Kessa went to retrieve the snow fox. The rest of us kept watch by the truck, anxiously awaiting his return.
Thank you.
The Snow Fox was dead. The Freedom Council had given us a mission, a chance to redeem ourselves after Copenhagen, and we had failed. Tuft had tracked us down and humiliated us, leaving the team spent, demotivated, and struggling. I needed to prove that they could still trust my leadership. Erikson and his men were bound to be well armed. If we planned to take them on, we would need firepower. And as it would turn out, even sleepy little Tinglev had a market for such things.
Thank you. Thank you.
Tinglev was becoming a hotbed of activity. While we had secured the weapons, Anders and Kessa had caught the doubled agent and learned that the Schalburg party would take place in the Falcon's Head and in a few hours to the north. We had our weapons and a destination. All that remained was to prepare for the day of reckoning.
Thank you.
Erikson was our target. Our path back into the Freedom Council's good graces. But luck would have it, Toft would be by his side. Tonight, we had a chance to kill two birds with one stone. It was time to tie up loose ends.
Thank you. groß kai kalt, stilken vild og så træt. Vil vi huske det år?
drove through the night, huddled in the back of Peter's truck. The events of the evening weighed heavy on our minds as the oppressive silence settled between us.
Thank you.